QuadJacks TV, and I'm so happy to be sitting down with Marcel Luske. Marcel, thanks so much for sitting down with us. It's great to see you again, sir.
Life is very nice to be here.
You were on our program a couple of months ago for 3 hours. If you'll remember,
we spoke a lot because I like to speak to give clarification to things you say and what's behind it, so it hasn't been taken wrong, and I like to explain things.
And we enjoyed having you, and we could have easily gone on for another 3. Now, among the things we discussed when you were on the program was this board game, Poker Champ, which I believe is manufactured and distributed in collaboration with FIDPA, if I'm pronouncing
that
correctly.
Yeah, we endorse it for FIDPA. From FIDPA. Because this is player friendly, there's no money involved, and it's all about entertainment, fun.
Right.
Family, friends should have fun playing any game.
Right.
And in this particular area, we are in the poker industry, and I was looking with my partners for a game of poker that could be based on fun.
Okay.
Not like you winning money and you winning, because of course the poker world will show on television the biggest games. But the people at home, they sit and they dream about being one time in Vegas, being one time in an EPT, being one time with poker stars at the final table. But the dream starts to learn the basics. And the basics, the best you learn with having fun doing something. You can lead a horse to the water, but you cannot make a drink.
Very well said.
If people understand the basics of the game directly without having to ask and feel stupid, then we'll pick it up, understand, and give it more respect.
Your goal is to popularize poker and also, you know, give it a more family-friendly image, it seems, or a more fun,
poker basically is a game that you can play for money, but you should play any card game for fun.
Right.
You should play any football game, any sport you do, you should have fun doing it. If you're good and you're one of the best, that's when the competition starts.
Yes. Marcel Luske has agreed very kindly to give us a demonstration of how Poker Champ works. I can't wait, Marcel.
Here's very simple. Of course, you have to go to the website.
Yes.
PokerChamp.net. To get the game, or go to the shop. But as the maybe in America,
or host QuadJacks.
QuadJacks.
Replace
but
me.
Here's the box.
All right.
There's normally it's sealed with plastic. I took it off.
By the way, this is completely, you know, unprepared, like everything else we do, after all.
So this is live, and this is. You come home, you bought the box, or we sent you the box. You open the box, and it's really very simple.
Mm-hmm.
Open the box. You got the rules in different languages.
Nice.
We kept very simple. Now here it's in 4 languages: English, French, German, and Dutch.
Okay.
The Dutch is the hardest one. Now, you get the board, and you can time the clock how long it takes.
Time the clock how long
it takes. It's simple. It's only a matter of a minute, 2 minutes.
Okay.
So there are characters on the board.
Yes.
You put the board on the table.
Yeah.
You got 6 seatings, and if you see, you got 1, 2, 3, and 4. This is the place you ante.
Okay.
And if you want to play, you place another one.
Yeah, okay.
And you place 2 chips on the turn and 2 on the river for the showdown.
Okay.
So it's simply, basically, the same like we normally do with poker. Everybody get 2 cards.
Okay.
Dealt. And you can play with 6 people. So if everybody who plays an ante is entitled to get cards.
Got it.
Now you get 12 tokens.
12 total? Chips?
Yes.
Okay.
Now, these are small tokens everybody get to place. 12 pieces each for each player.
Okay.
But the good thing about the tokens is, even when you lose them all, the one who's chip leader at that moment, he have to give you 6 tokens to restart.
Really?
Yes. And therefore, for this fair action of play, you will get an award. Now the awards here, you can put them in a plastic thing we have on the site. I don't want to make it too messy.
That's all right.
So
this table has withstood.
You get plastic holders to put the award, so you put them on the side next to you. So now we can see who has the award, because that's important.
All
the one who actually got 2 awards wins the game. And there are 7 awards in the game, so everybody could have an award.
Mm-hmm.
And the one who get the last award becomes the winner.
Right.
But of course, you can play with less people and you play the whole game to get the most awards.
Right.
Or you can say whoever wins the first award. So you can time it to very fast, very long, or with heads-up play. You can change the antes into 1, 2, 3, 4. You can give it a lot of variations, but the basic variation is 1, 1, 2, 2.
Okay.
And here are the cards.
All right.
I brought the deck of cards in my pocket because I opened it to make sure the plastic is off.
Now, these are 52 cards.
52 cards.
All right.
Now, the back of the cards are marked ace is ace.
Right.
But we don't know which ace. So this is the ace of hearts. It could be that we have another ace of clubs.
Right, okay.
So with four aces, you don't never know which ace it is.
Right.
But all the cards, other cards are marked.
Other cards are marked with the suit.
With the suit, with the S from small, and one star. That means this is a 2, a 3, a 4, or a 5.
Got it. That's small.
Small. Medium is a 6, a 7, an 8, or a 9.
Got it.
And large is a 10, a jack, a queen, or a king. Now look at that. You got small, medium, large.
Got it.
Three regions.
Yeah.
The suits are showing.
The suits are shown.
It's a 1 out of 4
card.
Mm-hmm. It cannot be any other card than 2, 3, or 4, or 5.
Got
it. That counts for all the cards in the deck. So if we would have a game, quick.
Okay.
And you don't know anything about poker.
This is kind of cool.
If you don't know nothing about poker,
which
in your
I
life,
do not, to be quite honest.
And you play your ante, and you play with your family or friends.
Yeah.
Anybody can shuffle the cards from the family.
Yeah.
You don't mind. We don't mind how they shuffle. If they shuffle old fashioned or new or they're smart, they shuffle the cards, and they give two cards. You place them here. So your opponent can see the large, the size, and the stars.
All right.
This is three times. Not only you can see you got a big heart, so it must be a 10, jack, queen, or king.
The Tony G hand.
The M is medium, so you got two hearts. And this is a medium card. It could be a 10 and a 9.
Could be a 10 and a 9.
But it could be a king and a 6.
Eight. King and a 6, okay. Or 8 is large. No, 8 is
eight
medium.
8 is medium.
Okay.
So now, if we give the second opponent two cards.
Yeah.
And you can look at your cards. They're your cards.
Oh, nice. Thanks.
But so, sitting around it like this, and placing the cards like this, you place them like this because the star have to be upstairs. So, I can see you have a 3-star card. That's a large card.
The stars correspond to large and medium.
Yes.
Okay.
3 is large, 2 is medium,
got
1 is it.
Got it.
So we got 3 ways of looking at the cards, and you see always the same.
Yeah, so it's easy. Okay.
It's easy.
Yeah.
So now, let's say, here is the ace and a big spade. And here is a large card in diamond and a small spade. And now the flop comes, a jack, a queen, and a 9.
Mm-hmm.
So you're looking for a 10-8 or a 10-king or 2 diamonds. Now look at here. He got small diamonds, 2 diamonds.
Right.
But he got a large and a medium. He could have a 10 with a 9.
Yeah, he could. He could
here
have a 10,
you got 10. 2 small diamonds. So they know now from each other.
Right.
What he have. And he knows what he has.
Right.
Because
yeah.
He could have 2-3 and he could have 4-5.
Yeah, yeah.
If he's going to play now and he got the 5 deuce, he will not play. He got the 3 and a deuce.
Right. Okay.
He knows that if the diamond comes, he cannot beat him with a 4-5 diamond.
Right.
So he will not play the hand
if
he plays.
Yeah, they couldn't get any smaller than the deuce 3, so even the guy's got a 5.
So the guy will make a bigger flush.
And if it's that large even, it would be even easier to tell.
He was large, a king, and an ace.
Got it.
And the ace is hidden because this is a diamond. So he looks at 2, 4, 6, 7, 8 diamonds. He's not too worried about another diamond coming.
Mm-hmm.
Now, anybody who wants to carry on his hand with play, put the second token in place.
All right, well, I'm definitely playing this.
And the people who don't play, they give their cards back. So let's say he would play.
Yeah.
Definitely.
Like he got his... Right, okay.
And he would play with a king, We saw that.
So do you have to post one of these to even be dealt a hand?
No.
No? Okay.
Everybody can look at his own cards. Got you it. Start with a five-card hand. Yeah. You post your ante, and if you like to play, you post. You don't have to wait. You can post directly.
That's very interesting.
Because now you can bluff your opponent with posting quick. They think you have a good hand.
Right.
So they're looking at your cards. If you post quick, like, you must have a 10-8. Because you got a medium card and a large card, so you probably have 10-8, you have a straight. He has to make a flush. So this one needs a 10, but one 10 is probably dead. But two diamonds will go because this one cannot beat this one. So
that guy's just like, I'm out of here, right?
I'm out of here. This one goes like, well, you know, I need a 10. But this one probably got a 10, this one got a 10. Well, I try one more card, he plays. This one officially will play because he has a 10.
The guy has a 10. Right.
So he's going to act stupid but play the hand. So one from the top goes here.
Right.
And then the medium card, the miracle card, the 8 comes. He makes a straight. And now it's getting tricky because you might have a straight as well. Because this is a diamond 10 and you can have the hard 10.
Right.
You understand?
Yeah.
So there is a lot of possibilities in the game.
Sure.
Now, this one will go for the last card for sure. This one will think you have to put two because there is too much in the pot. So he works out, hey, I can get so much chips, 12. I still have a chance to win. How many cards? And now they're going to do the calculation if it's worth to invest another two. If you don't go, like he got A-Jack, he's going to stay two pair to make a full house. So let's say they stay in, and this card is coming, the 10. Now, the one with King Ace has the best hand.
Yeah.
So, he made a straight up with the ace. But everybody knows he had the ace, but nobody knows if he had the king.
He had the king, that's true.
They know if this is the king, he makes a straight to the ace. He didn't make the flush, so he passed. If you had a king there,
I flopped two pair. But
you flopped two pair, but see, the turn came in eight, it makes him a straight. You still go for the river card because you only have to put two.
I've drawn multiple times.
So, but you understand, you can make the combinations and see what you're up to.
Sure. Yeah. I mean, it's additional information. It's providing more information than a standard game of poker.
Now, this looks very simple because they give so much information.
Sure, right.
But on the other hand, it's very educational.
Right.
Because you have to be smart, make the combinations, and see for yourself what options you have.
Right.
So, especially the younger children on the schools, students, they like this to play this. But families at home.
Families, yeah.
Who have people who play poker in their family and they're here and they see on television, they like to know about the game, how it's going.
Sure.
But they don't like to play for money. They want to have the fun.
Right, exactly.
They still want to understand the basics and what it's all about. And like this, it's a fun game.
Mm-hmm.
Because
seems like it. It really does.
If you think about it, it's the normal game of Hold'em.
Right.
And you would play this and you would get dealt two cards like this.
All right, so I have to put these with the stars facing. Right.
And now you start with a five-card hand. So you look who's having two diamonds, who's having big cards, who's having medium cards. He got two big cards, but they're both spread. So he can have the king, but not two kings, because they're both spread.
Right.
You have medium and small. You could have a seven and a five, and it wants to go for a six.
Mm-hmm. Those are small, so
this can be 4-5.
4-5, yeah.
Two spades. He needs spade, or 7-6 to make a straight.
Got it.
But it's not really a hand to play. Look, 5 deuce.
Yeah.
So on the back of the cards, he cannot bluff. He can only have a pair of nines with an ace. Pair of eight with an ace. You can have medium card in heart. You understand? So there is a lot of bluff.
It's very sophisticated. It can be a very sophisticated game.
It is intriguing.
Yes.
You have to calculate, and before you know, you sit in a simple game, but looks very simple.
Yeah.
But if you start to do the math and get involved, then you could have a 9 and a 3, mm-hmm. but he could have an 8 and an ace.
Right.
So he wants you out, but I don't think you should go out, because this cannot be an 8 of spades.
Right.
This must be a 9, but if it's a 9, but it is not. So now you have a 3 to 1 in your favor to play the hand if you have the 9. Because he can have a 6, a 7, or a 9. The 8 is there. You understand?
Mm-hmm.
It's a medium card. So this must be a 6, a 7, or a 9. Because this is a medium, and we only have 4 mediums.
It's almost like a blend of hold'em and a little bit of stud as well. Or,
yes.
You know?
So if you look at the possibilities, yeah, of the cards and the combination, then you say, so he can have only ace 9, or he have nothing,
right.
ace high.
Okay.
So the one who have a pair here, that you have, I
right.
think. No, you don't have a pair. But you can act like you have a pair.
That's what I was going to say, like, so the bluffing element.
Yes.
Where does that enter?
So if on the end this comes, and let's say this.
Right.
You have a small and a medium, and you would be only with him in the hand. You put your 2 on the end.
Right.
And he missed. So he's going to fold. But you know
right.
that his ace was good.
Okay. I see.
So there's a lot of fun.
There's a lot of fun.
And the one who actually ends up with winning the pot, and the ones who actually...
The pot are these, you know, these little tokens.
Yes.
Little plays. Okay.
So the one who wins, if somebody loses all the chips...
Right. It has to be given 6 by the chip leader,
yes.
and that person gets...
He gets the award, and when you get 2 awards. But there is another thing. If I have only 1 chip left,
yeah.
and normally I should call the river with my last chip, because there's value, but I know I have no chance, because the back of the cards tell me, for 99% I know I cannot win the hand, I should stay, hold on to the last chip, because
right.
the next game I play, I'm all in with 1 chip, but in order for you to win the hand, you must play it out. That means
right.
you must bet every time
right.
1, 1, 2, 2,
mm-hmm.
6 chips. If you have to play it out, I can get value from my 1 chip if I win that particular hand. Everyone who goes with me to the river pays 6 times and
right.
I can win it all.
Right, yeah, there's
so
no side pots or anything.
No side pots. So now the fun is, with even my last chips,
you
I can build
chance.
Up a chance.
Wow.
It's really...
It really looks like fun.
It is.
Marcel.
It's fun to play.
And when did you introduce this? How long ago?
We have it 2 months ago. We start to introduce it in Belgium.
Uh-huh.
My partner is Belgian, Pierre Neville. And there's another partner. We were 3 of us. He's familiar with Hasbro. He worked for Hasbro like
mm-hmm.
40 years of his
okay.
life. He knows the toy industry. And we are very happy with the game the way it is. We will do it in many languages.
You're looking for an introduction in the American market.
And we want to have the support from big organizations like Card Player, Poker News, PPA,
QuadJacks. Oh, yes, all right.
And QuadJacks. And QuadJacks.
Thank you. Thank you so
no,
much.
No, but
this was fun.
This is. Another thing is, the figures of the people in the game, on the pub.
Mm-hmm.
When you sit down, you really get the cards dealt like this,
mm-hmm.
and everybody takes a seat, because we don't want nobody to say, no, I want to sit there, I want to sit there. If you want, you can do that. But if you want to say, no, everybody draw, you draw a card.
I take
and
this.
And then you know where you sit.
The king pro.
You're the king pro,
yeah.
so the king pro sit here on the
yeah.
board.
Yeah.
This is your seat.
Oh,
you turn
okay.
it around. For the people who never play poker,
wow,
and you look
this
at
is very useful.
Looking at the card combinations.
Right.
Now, this is because people can more easily read the combinations of the cards and what they're up to. Now you can understand most people who have joined at home, families,
right.
normal families, don't go and travel all year in casinos
mm-hmm.
and poker clubs, but they see the game on television.
Right.
They have a game they can play at home, have fun, and understand what's going on television in the casinos,
sure.
EPTs,
because that's the because they can see the whole cards and everything
yes.
like that. Wow. It sounds like so much fun. So very well done. Congratulations to you and the people with whom you work to put this together.
Yes.
Let's set up a home game. What do you think? Let's, you know, we talk to a lot of pros here at QuadJacks. It'd be cool to get
if you want to get
a little game going. That'd be fun.
You set up a home game, and I'd be
awesome.
I'd be happy to join and be there, of course.
Yeah.
So let me know when you want to do it, and then I'll leave you this. I'll leave you the game, of course.
Just for us?
Yeah.
Thank you.
Because, and then I will give you another one.
Oh really?
To do something for the listeners.
Mm-hmm. Oh wow.
I'm sure you have a couple of people listening.
A few.
So, if there's a few more listening, we can do it one more time.
Yeah.
But I brought one more box, because as a giveaway for however you want to do it.
Oh really? This is for us? This is pretty cool. Sure. We can think of something.
The cards are here,
That. That we got technical cards.
Because this is what I explained to the people.
Nice.
So you can do a nice quiz to them.
Absolutely, absolutely. We're going to find a way to make it fun. We really
will. And I will stop by in the booth.
Please do.
And we'll have more fun. And let me know when you make something and do
absolutely.
Something with people.
Absolutely.
About the new game.
Thanks so much, Marcel Luske.
Thank you.
Come by again. You know where to find us?
Yes.
Where are you playing now? Are you going to be playing today?
I'm going to play some cash, meet some people.
Okay.
Don't forget to mention that people can find this on www.pokerchamp.net.
.net.
Or on my website. They just click on the PokerChamp and they come on the page. But more important, this has nothing to do with money. The only time you spend money is when you order a box.
Mm-hmm.
And the rest is you have fun with the family.
Well, it's a very nice thing that you're
it's
doing.
It's really any age can play, and it gives you more quality time. I remember when I played with my family at home. We have a big family. I got three brothers and five mm-hmm. sisters. And every Sunday afternoon we played all kind of card games. And everybody came to our house. You know,
right.
We were not a big house, but we had like 20, 25 people in the house
right.
because so many brothers and sisters. And we always played card games, any kind of card games. And it gives you more synergy and good feeling.
I agree.
You know,
if it's
not all about the money.
You're right.
But it's a great base to understand the game. And if you dream to come to Las Vegas, then if you have played this, you understand the basics of the game.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and you're not surprised by people having a better hand, outplay you that easy, because you get a much better read on your opponent's hand. And you can do the calculation much better when you play this.
Thank you, Marcel.
I'll stop by.
Thanks so much
time.
For the gifts, and looking forward to seeing you next time.
Okay, thank you very much.